In this example, we calculate the mole fraction of a component in a mixture with two volatile liquids using vapor pressure. Our problem reads, a solution contains a mixture of hexane and pentane at 30 degrees Celsius. The vapor pressures of pure hexane and pentane at 30 degrees Celsius are 186 millimeters of mercury and 612 millimeters of mercury, respectively. If the vapor pressure of the solution is 236 millimeters of mercury, calculate the mole fraction of hexane, assuming ideal behavior. Let's start by collecting the information we're given and relating it to the equations that govern vapor pressure. We're told the vapor pressure of the solution is 236 millimeters of mercury. The solution is composed of two volatile liquids, so the vapor pressure of the solution is also equal to the sum of the vapor pressures from hexane and pentane. The vapor pressure from hexane is equal to the mole fraction of hexane times the vapor pressure of the pure hexane at this temperature. Likewise, the vapor pressure from pentane is equal to the mole fraction of pentane times the vapor pressure of pure pentane. We're given both the vapor pressure of pure pentane and pure hexane, so we can substitute these values in. Right now, we have one equation with two unknowns, since we don't know the mole fraction of hexane or pentane. However, we do know one more equation that relates the mole fraction of hexane and pentane. Since the solution has only two components, adding together the mole fraction of both components gives us the number 1. We want to know the mole fraction of hexane, so we can rearrange this equation to put the mole fraction of pentane in terms of the mole fraction of hexane. The mole fraction of pentane equals 1 minus the mole fraction of hexane. Substituting this expression for the mole fraction of pentane into our equation, we'll have one equation with one unknown. And this we can solve with algebra. First, we'll want to use the distributive property to multiply 1 minus the mole fraction of hexane by 612 millimeters of mercury. Next, we'll get all of the numbers on the left side by subtracting 612 millimeters of mercury from both sides. Then we can complete the subtraction on both sides, combining the numbers and coefficients for the mole fraction of hexane. And finally, we can divide by the coefficient of the mole fraction of hexane. And we should get 0.883 for the mole fraction of hexane. If we were also asked for the mole fraction of pentane, it would be 1 subtract 0.883.